हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वंस अगेन यू आर मोस्ट वेलकम हियर। दिस टाइम वी आर स्टडिंग चैप्टर फर्स्ट फ्रॉम द सेकेंड बुक विस्टास, दैट इज़ द थर्ड लेवल। नाउ लेट्स प्रोसीड दिस पेज। देयर इज प्रोबेबली अ लॉन्ग टनल दैट नोबडी नोज अबाउट, फीलिंग इट्स वे अंडर द सिटी राइट नाउ, ऑन इट्स वे टू टाइम्स स्क्वायर and maybe another to Central Park, and maybe because for so many people through the years Grand Central has been an exit, a way of escape. Maybe that's how the tunnel I got into, but I never told my psychiatrist friend about that idea. Before this passage, students, you have read that at the night when the narrator Charlie was on the way to his apartment, he was confused and he entered inside of the Grand Central Station, and he was now into a tunnel and confused so much that now where he had to go. So here he says that maybe nobody has idea about this tunnel, this long tunnel, that this is under the city right now, and they know that this is the only way to come out at that place Times Square, and or to this is an exit place to another place Central Park. And again he says that maybe some people thinks that this place Grand Central stations, this place is only for an exit, for a way for the people who wants to use it to escape themselves. As he has also entered into this tunnel, and now he has realized that this is the way to escape someone from this world, from the misery of this world, for the security. And so about all this confusion, when he was talking everything to his friend, he never mentioned all about it to his psychiatrist friend, that how he was moving, how he was confusing at that time when he was under the Grand Central Station. Now the corridor I was in began angling left and slanting downward, and I thought that was wrong, but I kept on walking. Now the narrator says that in the corridor where he was moving, it had moved left, and again he found a slope towards the downward area. Then again he was confused that this way is wrong to him, but he ignored this idea and he continued on walking. All I could hear was the empty sound of my own footsteps, and I didn't pass a soul. Then when he moved to a distance, after that he realized that there is no more sound except of his footstep. So here he is something stunned at that time, as there was no other sound there. Then I heard that sort of hollow roar ahead, that means open space and people talking. Meanwhile he heard the sound, the hurrying sound, and he realized that now there is an open place, and definitely he found a place and where some people was talking to each other. The tunnel turned sharp left and there was an exit where the tunnel had turned sharply in the left side. I went down a short flight of stairs and came out on the third level at Grand Central Station. Now the narrator says that after that he went down and after taking some steps of stairs, finally he came out on the third level of the place which was fully unknown to anyone. Now he was at the third level at the Grand Central Station. For just a moment I thought I was back on the second level. At that time, seeing the scenes, the sight of the place, the narrator thought that maybe he is again on the second level. But I saw the room was smaller, there were fewer ticket windows and train gates. Now, to clear his doubts, he started to observe the things, but he found the different rooms and different ticket windows there according to the second and first level. And the information booth in the center was wood and old looking. He also noticed that the information booth at that place was also made of wood and it was looking very old. And the man in the booth wore a green eyeshade and long black sleeve protector. And there he again saw a very strange sight. There was a man and who had used a green eyeshade over his eyes. He had also used long black sleeve as a protector. This sight was something strange for him, and he is looking very disturbed and in confusion to see this sight, as he had never seen such type of scene sight at that time at the first and the second level of the Grand Central Station. The light were dim and sort of flickering. और अगेन कह रहा है कि फिर उसने नोटिस किया कि लाइट्स भी काफ़ी डिम थे और जो भी थे वो भी फ्लिकरिंग कर रहे थे. फ्लिकरिंग मतलब होता है रुकना, बंद होना, धुक धुक करके जलना और कंटिन्यू नहीं लाइट को देना, रुक रुक करके जलना, इस तरह को फ्लिकर कर रहा था. एंड देन आई सा व्हाई दे वर ओपन फ्लैम गैस लाइट. And after that, once again, the narrator started to think about the condition that in this age when there is fully electricity, all the facilities are present. After that, they had used Petromax, they had used gas light. This was something thinkable for the narrator at that time. Now, there were brass spittons on the floor. Spittons को स्पीट को आप इसको तोड़ देंगे. स्पीट में थूकना होता है. फिर उसने नोटिस किया था brass spittons on the floor. फ्लोर पे brass spittons था. brass कुछ थूकने वाले बर्तन रखे हुए थे, इसमें थूका जाए. तो ये सब काफ़ी बहुत ही ओल्ड टाइम्स को शो कर रहा था, क्योंकि प्रेजेंट टाइम में ब्रश के वहाँ पे बिन्स, डस्टबिन्स टाइप में वहाँ पे जो भी पॉट्स थे ऐसे नहीं रखे गए थे, रखे जाते थे. एंड अक्रॉस द स्टेशन
A glint of light caught my eye.
Meanwhile, he ran his eye and he found across the station that his eyes was also caught with a light, and he saw that a man was pulling a gold watch. The man was pulling a gold watch from his waist pocket. अपने पॉकेट से गोल्ड वॉच को निकाल कर देखा. He snapped open the cover, glanced at his watch and frowned. Snapped open the cover. जो कवर था उस कवर को उसने he removed it. And after that he noticed the watch very attentively at that time. This sight was also different for him. He wore a derby hat, a black 4-button suit with the tiny lapels, and had a big black handlebar mustache.
Now he saw the man. The man had used a derby hat, and also he had used a suit included with 4-button, and also his mustache was handlebar mein super circular ho, jo haath se log usko ghumate hain upar ki taraf circular karke, to is tarah se mustache kafi badi upar circular mode mein is kafi ek attractive scene tha. Then I looked around and saw that everyone in the station was dressed like 18-19 something. Aur phir करा कि जब वो नोटिस किया एट द इनसाइड ऑफ द स्टेशन ही फाउंड द ड्रेसिंग सिस्टम ऑफ द पीपल हु वर प्रेजेंट देयर इट मैच्ड विद द 1890 समथिंग. आई नेवर सॉ सो मेनी बियर्ड्स साइड बर्न्स एंड फैंसी मस्टैच इन माई लाइफ. बियर्ड्स में चूंकि काफ़ी हैवी बियर्ड्स थे, जो बियर्ड्स उस तरह के बियर्ड्स प्रेजेंट टाइम में नहीं देखा था, और साइड बर्न्स में कान के आसपास की जो उस समय की डिजाइनिंग बाल के बने रहते थे उसको बोलते हैं, तो उस साइड बर्न्स और इस तरह के बियर्ड्स मुस्टैच वाली पर्सनैलिटी के लोगों को कभी नरेटर ने इस एरिया में नहीं नोटिस किया था. सो इट इज़ लुकिंग वेरी डिफरेंट टू हिम. अ वुमन वॉक्ड इन थ्रू द ट्रेन गेट. शी वोर अ ड्रेस विद लैग गो मटन स्लीव्स एंड स्कर्ट्स टू द टॉप ऑफ हर हाई बटन शू. एंड देन ही नोटिस्ड अ वुमन. शी वॉज वॉकिंग थ्रू द ट्रेन गेट. हर ड्रेसिंग सेंस वॉज मटन स्लीव्स, लेग गो मटन स्लीव्स ड्रेस. You can see this dress on the Google, the appearance of this dress. And also she had used the skirts to the top, and her shoe were also high buttoned shoe. Back of her out on the tracks, just behind her, when the narrator Mac run his sight, he saw a glimpse of a locomotive. एक ट्रेन का उसने दृश्य देखा. अ वेरी स्मॉल करियर, एक काफ़ी छोटी करियर एंड टाइप्स लोकोमोटिव, एक काफ़ी छोटी ट्रेन की जो कंपनी थी विद अ फनल शेप्ड स्टैक, जिसमें फनल की तरह भट्टी की तरह आकार उसमें बनी हुई थी. एंड देन आई न्यू एंड देन ही न्यू ऑल अबाउट इट दैट इन विच पीरियड सच टाइप ऑफ ट्रेन्स एंड all the things were used. He understood it very clearly. To make sure, I walked over to a newsboy and glanced at the stack of papers at his feet. Now for the surety of his thinking, he make run his ideas, and now he saw a newspaper boy it was the world, the newspaper was the world, and the world hasn't been published for year. मतलब सोचने लगा कि द वर्ल्ड न्यूज़पेपर तो फिर काफ़ी कई सालों से पब्लिश ही नहीं हुआ. फिर द लीड स्टोरी सेड समथिंग अबाउट प्रेसिडेंट क्लीवलैंड. फिर प्रेसिडेंट क्लीवलैंड के बारे में स्टोरी वहाँ पे दिया हुआ था, ये भी काफ़ी एक उसके लिए एक डिफरेंट थिंग थी, काफ़ी अलग चीज़ थी उसके लिए प्रेसिडेंट क्लीवलैंड के लिए यहाँ पे दिया हुआ. सो आई फाउंड दैट फ्रंट पेज इन द पब्लिक लाइब्रेरी फाइल एंड इट वॉज प्रिंटेड June 11, 1994. और जब उसने अगले पेज को भी जब उसने देखा तो पब्लिक लाइब्रेरी फाइल्स उसमें मिला और जो प्रिंटिंग डेट था वो 1894 का था. अर्थात उसमें 1894 की में वो चला गया, 1894 की टाइम पीरियड को नोटिस करने लगा कि उस दौरान की सारी चीज़ें इस समय क्यों यहाँ पे मेंशन हुई है. सो ऑल दिस थिंग्स वाज वेरी कंफ्यूजिंग फॉर हिम एंड ही इज आल्सो लुकिंग एक्सट्रीमली अपसेट टू सी ऑल दिस साइट एट दैट टाइम.